Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to design and create your own fantasy action video game logo. Make a new document by pressing Ctrl N on Windows or Command N on a Mac. Make the width 1580 pixels, the height 922 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. To view the document at 100% in size, press Ctrl or Command plus the number 1. Fill it with black by pressing Alt or Option plus Delete if your foreground color is black. However, if your background color is black, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font. I'm using a font called Wolfsbane, which you can download at searchfreefonts.com. For this font, I'll choose a size of 140 points, sharp, and left alignment. Click on the color box and pick white. Type out the name of your video game. If you want to increase the size of a character, highlight it and increase its size. I'll increase it to 180 points. Go to Window and Character. The Character panel will open. Go to the Baseline Shift icon and slide it to the left to lower the baseline of the character, thereby centering it. I'll make it minus 16 points. Then, close the Character panel. To center the text on your document, click on your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A. Click on the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. To delete the selection, press Ctrl or Command D. Click on the FX icon and choose Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is chisel hard, the direction is down, and the size is 250 pixels. Keep in mind, you may want to adjust the layer style amounts depending on the size and resolution of your document, as well as the characteristics of the font you're choosing. Uncheck Global Light and make the angle 90 degrees and the altitude 26 degrees. Click on the color box for the highlights and pick a light color. I'm picking a light blue. BEDAFF. Click Gradient Overlay. The gradient is black to white, the blend mode is normal, the opacity is 100%, the style is linear, the angle is 90 degrees, and the scale is 100%. Click Inner Glow and the color box. I'm picking a bright red, FF and 4 zeros. Change the blend mode to hard mix. Make the technique precise and the source is center. Make the choke 50% and the size 20 pixels. Click the arrow next to the contour box and click the fourth thumbnail, which is called Cove Deep. Click Outer Glow and the color box. Pick black and change the blend mode to normal. Make the spread 16% and the size 13 pixels. Click drop shadow. The blend mode is multiply and the opacity is 75%. Uncheck global light and make the angle minus 146 degrees. Make the distance 50 pixels and the size 20 pixels. Then click OK. If you want to place a character behind your text, go below the word and press T to open your type tool. Type the character, highlight it, and increase its size. I'm increasing it to 300 points. Ultimately, we want to make the color of the letter black, but in order to see it on the background, for now, we'll leave it as white. We'll change it to black after we add effects to it. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. Since we want the character to go behind your other text, drag the character layer below your other text layer. To reposition the character one pixel at a time, use your arrow keys on your keyboard. In this case, I'd like to move it to the right, so I'll press the right arrow key until it's centered. Click on the FX icon and choose Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is chisel hard, the direction is down, and the size is 16 pixels. Uncheck Global Light and make the angle 90 degrees and the altitude 26 degrees. Make the highlight opacity 0. Click Inner Glow and the color box. Pick the same bright color that you picked earlier and click OK. Make the blend mode normal, the opacity 50%, the technique precise, and the source center. Make the choke 50% and the size 20 pixels. Click Outer Glow and change the blend mode to normal, and the opacity is 100%. Click on the color box and pick the same light color as you picked earlier. Make the size between 150 and 250 pixels. I'm choosing 180 for this example, then click OK. Now we can change the color of the character from white to black. Double-click on the thumbnail of your character to highlight it. Click on the color box and pick black. Next, we'll transform the outer glow into an electronically charged storm field. Open your Move tool and click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Make sure the new layer is directly above your character. We'll fill it with black. To do this, first make the foreground color black by pressing D on your keyboard, and then press Alt-Delete on Windows or Option-Delete on a Mac. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds, and then Filter, Render, and Difference Clouds. To repeat the last filter, press Ctrl or Command F. Repeat it approximately a dozen times to increase its complexity. Then change its blend mode to Color Dodge. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.